and we're gonna have our final logo added to the portfolio, and it's gonna make us stand out as designers, and it's gonna be really great. Hey, hello guys. Today I'm going to teach you how to make these covers. And to make these covers, we're going to start with Adobe Illustrator. The dimensions of the file are going to be 808 by 632. And we're going to name it animated cover portfolio. Okay, we're going to create a new this new file. I'm going to paste a logo that I already had. I'm going to put this in the description of the video so you can follow along this video. So it's going to be fine. The first step is going to be resizing the logo in a size we're going to feel comfortable using. Something like that will be fine. And then I'm going to make like a square of the same size of the logo. I'm going to send this to the back. We're going to select the logo here in Adobe Illustrator. And we're going to change the color of this to 1F1F1. I think that's gonna be good. Maybe make it a little bit greenish just to make it go a little bit, but not too much. Well, I have an idea. What if we take the color of the background and we start just from there? What if we start just making it lighter, right? And then just bring it closer. So it gives us a greenish tone of the white that's gonna make it blend better with the background. I think that's gonna look really good. So yeah, we have now we have this logo right here that we're gonna use. The first step will be to let me put the layers right here. It's the best. I normally use the layers in the left side. I just got used to doing this way. And what I'm gonna do with this is I'm gonna take these layers and I'm gonna select all the items, and I'm gonna ungroup everything. If it's grouped, for example, the logo, I need to ungroup it, and then I'm just gonna make sure that everything is ungrouped. Okay, I'm gonna select everything. I'm gonna click here in this little part of the layers. I'm gonna select release into a layer sequence. This is an important step that we need to do before we start working in After Effects. We're gonna select all the layers. We're gonna take them out of the composition. You know, out of the main layer. I'm not gonna delete the main layer. We don't need that for now. I'm gonna start naming all the layers. I know this is tedious, but stay with me. This is background. Okay, we're gonna select the G. Oh, this is the R. This is the E. This is the other E. This is the N. This is the B. This is the I. I'm gonna call this one the dot of the eyes leaf. And we're gonna name the N. Okay, so we have our layer separated as a sequence. So we're gonna take all this and we're gonna start press Command Shift S, and we're gonna save this maybe in the desktop. We're gonna create a new folder, animated cover for portfolio. We're gonna create okay, animated cover portfolio. We're gonna save this and just press okay in everything. The next step will be going to After Effects. Okay, we're gonna create a new file in After Effects, and here the first step will be to create a new composition from footage. And we're gonna go back to the desktop, and here we're gonna select the animated cover for portfolio. And we're gonna select it. And this is really crucial, guys. You gotta change the import as setting, selecting composition, retain layer sizes. And we're gonna press there. I'm gonna press open. It's gonna bring us this composition already into view. We're gonna select this composition that we have right here. And we're gonna we have the background right there. We're gonna select all the letters, and I'm gonna pre-compose them. Okay. We're gonna name this like logo animation. And then we're gonna do where double click the logo right there. Having these letters, we're gonna select the G, the E, the N, the I, and we're gonna leave it there. We're gonna press P for position. We're gonna create a position keyframe. Okay, we're gonna go back all the way to the beginning, and then we're gonna change the position all the way down, something like that. It's supposed to do this when we play. It's supposed to go up when we play. We're gonna do the opposite with the other layers. So we're gonna select the R, the E, the B, and the N. And these ones are gonna do the opposite movement. So we're gonna stand in the 16 frames, and we're gonna press P, and then we're gonna create an anchor point. We're gonna create a keyframe, and this keyframe, we're gonna go all the way to the beginning, and we're gonna change the position up in the opposite, so all the way up. They're supposed to go like this. Let me go to the beginning. Wait a second. They need to go higher. Like that will be fine. So we're gonna have something like they just join together at the same time, which is fine. The next step will be selecting the leaf of the eye. We're gonna stop there, and we're gonna press S for scale, and then we're gonna create a new keyframe. We're gonna move it to the 20 frames, and then we're gonna change this to 100, sorry. And I'm gonna click the first keyframe, sorry about that. I'm gonna put 0, and it should go from 0 like that. So it should be something like really simple animation, okay? But we gotta spice it up. This doesn't look really good. So the next step I think we could do is selecting the layers, and then just pressing option and the arrow in the keyboard. We're gonna go 1, two, three times. We're gonna select again all the layers, one, two, three times, all the layers. I'm gonna do it all over again, you know, selecting all the layers, and then one, two, three, and then we just keep doing it. Things that's already was moved, one, two, three, and then one, two, three, and here three times as well. I'm just doing this to make things go a little bit, you know, not at the same time. So it's gonna be like boom, 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 boom. There we have the animation right there. One thing I like to change is that it's kind of a slow pressing option or alt. We're gonna drag the keyframes a little more together so they go a little faster. And it's gonna give me something like this. Okay, we can use different types of ways to make it look more like motion graphics by selecting all the keyframes. And we're gonna go to keyframe assistant and we're gonna click ease in, and it's gonna fix the keyframes. And they're gonna make them more snappy. It looks like more like motion graphics, and it's gonna look kind of nice. Let me put them a little bit more together. Pressing option, I'm just gonna try to drag them a little bit more together. Maybe this is gonna help. Pressing option, okay. Let me select them again. Pressing option, just make them a little bit more tight like that. That'll be fine. And it's gonna be like, okay, that looks actually cool. One thing that you could do, this is an extra thing. Normally I use this plugin. This is not paid or advertised or anything. But since I start doing After Effects, most of my stuff I do it with this plugin named Motion 4. It's by MTMograph. I'm gonna put it in the description below. And what it does, it just helps me create the default easings, and it has easings already there in the software. And I normally like to do, for example, this type of easing would make it look a little better. I'm just double clicking it and it's gonna give me a different type of easing, a little bit softer, subtle. I'm gonna take this one right here. I'm gonna do it with this one, more snappier. And then I'm just gonna, okay, we have the animations there. Okay, this has to be a little bit separated. And let's just do something like this. Okay, this is good. And let's try to see the animation again. Okay, that looks great. So the next step will be going back to the animated cover. And there what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a mask, okay? So when the logo comes in 1 second, we're gonna select the square and we're gonna create a mask that goes on top of the logo itself, okay? Just to make it look a little better when the animation goes. So it's gonna be like this, okay? Here started the logo animation. One thing we can actually add to this is the scale. We're gonna add a little bit of a scale to this. Let me just try to make it scale. Let's make it in 1 second. Okay, let's press scale right here. This stays into 100 and then we just make it way bigger. And let's see how it goes. There you go. It stays there in animation. And let's take this 2 seconds, 2 seconds. Okay. The next step will be to take these layers and pre-compose them. Okay. We're gonna press and in the pre-compositions, we're gonna reduce the size. We're gonna go composition settings and we're gonna change the length of this composition to 0.3 seconds. Maybe 0.3 seconds gonna be fine. 0.00. Okay, we're gonna go back to the logo animation, the animated portfolio right here. It's gonna be like a 2 second composition. Okay, and we're gonna do we're gonna duplicate this layer. I'm gonna select here time. I'm gonna go to the selecting the new layer that we created after pressing D. We're gonna command D. We're gonna code time, and then we're gonna go to time reverse layer. Okay, and we're gonna try to match them like this. Let's see if this works. Okay, let's see if that it should be like the logo comes there, and it's supposed to go out. There you go. So we're gonna go to the composition settings. And here in the composition settings, what we're gonna do is we're gonna change the time of the entire composition to 0.0600. So 6 seconds length total. And then we're gonna press okay. And it's gonna be the animated cover. Let me see for the portfolio. And it should be good at this point. Okay, let's try to see it again. Okay, it comes to the logo there. It stays for a little bit and then it goes out. Same way it came in. That's it. Really simple. So we're gonna go to file and we're gonna go to export, add to Media Encoder queue. I normally use Media Encoder in this type of situations is because it gives me more options. It's more flexible to give me different formats, and it's gonna help you a lot if you wanna export better quality video because it has more features. It's a really underrated program from Adobe, so it's gonna help you a lot. Okay, here in Media Encoder, it's gonna send the information from After Effects all the way to Media Encoder. This is gonna help us a lot because we're rendering our animated cover in Media Encoder. Now that we have our cover in Media Encoder, we're gonna select this part where it says H.264. We're gonna select it. It's gonna do the dynamic link to the server. It's gonna take a little bit, but I promise it's worth it. We're gonna go into the settings here in the Media Encoder, and we're gonna make sure that the format is gonna be animated GIF, and we're gonna scroll down a little bit and we're gonna render at maximum depth, and we're gonna use the maximum render quality. We're gonna click the output and we're gonna select the output to be, let me select here in the desktop, animated card portfolio, and put final cover. create logo animated cover as a name, and we're gonna click save. We're gonna press okay, and we're gonna click this green play button to start the rendering queue, and we're gonna just gonna wait till the magic happens. It's gonna give us a GIF at the end that is gonna be something like this. Let me show you guys. I'm gonna double click here just to show you what I have right here in the final cover. We have this animated GIF, which is fine, GIF or GIF, but the size of the GIF is too high. It's 11 megabytes and it's not website friendly. For this, I have this secret tip that I mentioned at the beginning of the video. You gotta go to a website. You're gonna go to this website, compressgif.com, okay? Here, we're gonna go back to our desktop and we're gonna double click the final animated GIF that we created and we're gonna drag it on top of this queue. It's gonna take a little bit, but it's gonna do a conversion. It's gonna optimize as much as possible. This is completely free, guys, so don't worry about it. You're just gonna drag it and drop it there, and it's gonna compress it as much as possible. And the great news is it's gonna give you a file with a really low like file size that is gonna be really, really good for websites, and it's gonna be really web friendly. We just wait to have with this compression happening, and then we're gonna be able to download it and try to add it to the portfolio, guys. Stay with me. Now we have our file compressed, and it's reduced 95% of the size of the file. So this is amazing. This is great. This is not gonna be as heavy. So if we compare the normal version, which was, again, guys, it was 11 megabytes. Yeah, we compare that with this new animated cover min, which is minified. Look at this. This is gonna be 542 kilobytes, which is perfect for the uses or purposes that we have right now. I'm gonna go back to the portfolio, guys, that I was working with you guys, where I teach you how to build your portfolio. And here we're gonna create a new page, okay? This is gonna be a new page. We're gonna name it Green Bean, where we're gonna add the logo. We're gonna press okay. We're gonna go back to the pages. We're gonna select all the projects at home. And here is where I'm gonna upload a cover. It's gonna ask me to upload a cover. We're gonna go here, we're gonna upload an image, we're gonna go back to the desktop, we're gonna double click here, we're gonna go to the final cover, and we're gonna use the minify version of the GIF that we created before. We're gonna press open, and it's gonna take a little bit, it's gonna upload it and optimize it for the web, and we're gonna have our final logo added to the portfolio, and it's gonna make us stand out as designers, and it's gonna be really, really, really great. And this is gonna give us our wonderful, wonderful GIF in our portfolio. It's gonna help you stand out. It helped me get my first job in the United States, and I got multiple jobs just because of my portfolio, because I actually went the extra mile and tried to animate the covers of my portfolio in Adobe Portfolio. If you feel like you learned something new, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.